Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding refugees, the children of modernity, written by G. Sampath. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for geography and public administration and political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the illegal migration and refugees should not be compared on a similar and same standard. This editorial is also about how the creation of nation and state is against the natural nature of a man. This editorial is also about how the international community should be responding to the rising specter of refugees. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand the nature of man and the nature of a nation and a state. Now, as far as the nature of a man is concerned, man is an exploratory being. Man is a being which likes to travel. Man is a being which don't like to be in boundations. Man is a being which do not want to restrict himself. Man is a being which wants to explore and enrich and to live. So this is actually a nature of man. Now, on the other hand, we have a nature of a state and a nature of a nation. Now, as far as the nature of a state and nation is concerned, the phenomenal characteristic of a nation and a state is that it is defined by a boundary. It is defined by an area. It is defined by the limits. It is defined by the restrictions. It is defined by imposing certain duties on the citizens. Now, in order to understand why this refuge is increasing, why this migration is increasing, we need to know about how the human civilization has progressed. In the beginning phase of the human civilization, man was very free. And then came the concept of nation and state. Now this nation state is restricting the movement of man. So actually, what is happening, we have imposed a concept of nation on the human beings. This concept of nation and state was invented by the landlords. This concept of nation and state was invented by the people who wanted to hold big powers with them. This concept of nation and state is antithetical to the basic nature of man. The concept of nationalism is against the concept of universal brotherhood. The concept of nation and state is against the concept of the free will of a man. The concept of nation and state is against the will of a man to inquire, will of a man to explore, will of a man to enrich, and will of a man to feel autonomous. Now, when this is the nature of man, it is because of this very nature, we are witnessing this increase in the refuge. And what is generally considered by the world community, the people as refuge, is actually not a refuge. There is a bigger scope attached with this term refugees. Now, refugees are not only the people who have been displaced, who have been forced to go out of the country because of some disturbance going on there, but it also includes the people who wants to seek asylum. It also includes the people, according to the author, it also includes the people who have been displaced, internally displaced. It is also for those people who have been displaced because of the building up of the dams, the bridges, and making up of infrastructure. So refuge is nothing, it is actually a fight between the two forces. It is a fight between the forces who wants to acquire the entire resources. And when this symmetrical asymmetricalness set in the resource ownership, it creates a kind of repulsive feeling from the other people, and they begin to refuse from one area to the other area. They begin to migrate from one area to the other area. Now, what has been the world response to this refugees? Now, the European countries, they are not ready to absorb the people who are coming in from the countries like Syria, Yemen, and other disturbed countries of the Middle East. Now, why they are not accepting? They are not accepting because presently the kind of the system that we are having, United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, it does not have a strict provision. It is just a convention which actually stirs the country to be more compassionate, to be more enthusiastic about adopting the people from other country. But this enthusiasm and enthusiasticness on the part of the countries is lacking because of the poor economic conditions in the Europe. Now, what requires to be changed? Now, in the international fora, in the international institution that we are having, in the United Nations, and for that matter in the World Bank, we need to keep the economic dimension at a lesser level of the hierarchy than the rights of the human beings. Presently, what is happening is that we are considering each and everything from the perspective of economy. We are considering each and everything from the perspective of nation. We are not considering it from the perspective of human rights and the welfare of the humanism. Now, these things needs to replace the aspects of economy, the aspects of nation. These are less sacramental concepts. Nationhood, nationalism is certainly a less sacramental concept when you compare it with the concept of global humanism, global brotherhood, and the fraternity, cohesiveness. So, at the end of the day, what we need to create is universal brotherhood. Now, these things were put forward by the philosophers like Rabindranath Tagore, like Anuntya Kale. Now, they have come out with this idea of global citizenship. Because if we will think of global citizenship, only then we will be responsible to the rising menace of terrorism, the rising menace of climatic change, the rising menace of refugees, and the rising menace of fundamentalism. Because when we consider ourselves as a nationalistic person or a person imbibing this feeling of nationalism, we are actually identifying ourselves with one. When we identify ourselves with something, we actually tend to feel repulsive from the others. So this creates a kind of fault lines, and this creates the problem of why we have not been able to solve these problems of refugees, problems of climatic change, problem of terrorism, problem of fundamentalism. So the root cause is the cause of nationalism. So this is a kind of idealistic way of decoding this editorial. The life is not that idealistic. Panchi nadiyan pavan ke jhonke, koi sarhad na inhe roke. But that is not true for the humans. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And do write answers on brainiki.com. This will help you keep your preparation in momentum. Now you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you have liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And so this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.